All right, so our second video this week, similar to the conversation we were having earlier this week, is about the transition, the change out of our rooms and Zooms into connecting with people and community more so face-to-face as things open up. And I want to comment more specifically on technology and how our use of technology has become more dependent. I know myself, for example, over the course of the pandemic, my Instagram usage has skyrocketed. And that's not to say that it's a bad thing to use Instagram, but sometimes I find myself just drowning in Instagram and catching myself after a long period of doing so and saying, oh my goodness, I need to get outside and listen to a bird and see the sun. And so we find ourselves here in a pivotal moment where we have to have a choice. We have to make a choice as to whether or not we are going to continue to lean as heavily on technology, on Zoom, on Instagram, on Snapchat, Facebook. Are we going to continue to lean as heavily on these for our connection? Or as things start to open up, are we going to get out there and start to connect with people more face to face? And I think it's an important thing to pay attention to in our lives because, again, our norm has become to use technology more over the past year. And as things are changing, we don't necessarily have to do that so much. All right, again with us is Mr. David Wade. Thank you for having thank you for being here, David. We appreciate your insight and your perspective here. I want to ask you about your technology usage and how it's changed, starting with the course of the pandemic and over the past year.
Yeah, so definitely I've been in front of my computer a lot longer than I usually am. Usually it was specifically for either homework or if I just wanted to relax and play some games during the night. But now it's kind of just how you usually have hours of school during the day. Usually you would spend that in front of a lecture hall, in front of your professor, but now that's entirely replaced by being in front of your laptop or computer, going on a Zoom call and just spending all that time in front of the computer. It can be a little daunting for some people, and all that time can kind of put you into this habit or this little rut where you kind of become a little more comfortable spending time in front of technology. Definitely. With me spending more time with lectures in front of my computer using Zoom, my use of technology has gone way up. And I've definitely fallen victim to just realizing, oh, I just spent an entire day in front of my laptop, either doing a bunch of different things and not really going outside, doing the things I need to do, like work out or hang out with friends. So thankfully, I've been lucky enough to where I've had a bunch of people always trying to communicate with me, let me know, like, hey, let's go do this, let's go do that. And I'm not trying to say that you need to be lucky to get all the benefits that you should by not spending your time in front of technology, but definitely you just need to put that little bit of extra effort into trying to get yourself out of those habits that you're forming or that little schedule that you've been making yourself in front of your laptop or anything like that. So. Mm.
Thank you for sharing that. And I think you highlight really well kind of the propensity to get sucked in a little bit more than maybe we would like to, because we've been vulnerable in the pandemic to that. You know, we're in our room surrounded by technology, so it's easy to get drawn into that more than maybe we would like to. I think you also point out something that I think can be really helpful to students and residents is to have accountability buddies, you know, partners in crime who are saying, hey, let's get out, let's go do something that's not in our room, let's not Zoom this time, you know. Yeah. And even if it's a group of people that you're going to wear a mask around and you're not, you know, you can still walk outside and spend time outside and do so safely. And I think that that's a really awesome suggestion. I'm glad that you have had people to hold you accountable for that and get you out. And I encourage the other residents to find those connections where they can work on that together. Curious, I know earlier this week you were talking about how there was a bit of adjusting to getting to know people in person after being inside so long. I'm curious if you can comment on how social media use and kind of being used to interacting that way, if you are a social media user, or it sounds like you spend time gaming, which is also interacting, I'm sure, with other people as well, how that maybe has affected your abilities in kind of rewarming up to face-to-face interaction and connection.
Yeah, I think with always being on my phone, my main form of communication is texting with my friends or being on some sort of voice call with other friends whenever I want to like play games with them, stuff like that. You definitely kind of just fall into that rut where you're like, oh, I don't need to go talk face to face with them. We can just text, we can just have a call. We can even meet over Zoom if we want. So definitely it hasn't been too bad of a transition, because for the most part, these people that I talk to are people that I've known for years or I've known for a really long time. But definitely it's been getting me going out more often, trying to greet people. I have a bunch of residents that I always see and that I always say hi to. And it's just me, I'm just trying to train myself more, just get more comfortable with just going out and being more comfortable talking with people. Usually I'm not too bad, but definitely it's not an easy transition going from being so used to using your phone or computer as a medium as to going in and putting yourself out there, I guess. That's probably the part that's become harder, just putting yourself out there and trying to go out of your way to meet new people.
I appreciate and honor your willingness to step out of your comfort zone actively to push yourself into these positions that maybe feel uncomfortable considering the circumstances. You say, hey, I want to connect with people more face to face, and this is how you make those steps. Amazing. Thank you for sharing.
All right, so in summary, ironically, being delivered via technology, which we are meeting ourselves where we are at, which means that sometimes technology is a helpful tool to deliver these messages. But in summary, we have to ask ourselves the question, like, how much technology do we want preoccupying our lives? And as things open up, we have the chance to connect with community. And I'll tell you, as human beings, we need face-to-face contact. It's so important for our ability to thrive and feel good and feel supported and nourished. We're at a changing point where we have to pay attention to our technology use and choose a balance that is suited to us. Not to say that technology is a bad thing or that it's a problem to use social media or Zoom or that we shouldn't use it effectively, but my encouragement and David's encouragement is to pay attention to how it's affecting your life and how maybe getting out of our comfort zone a little bit and pushing ourselves to connect with people face to face, to say hi to people in the courtyards, to get outside with friends, maybe a little bit uncomfortable, but it's something that's worthwhile in the end. So this week, I hope that you get out and about and enjoy yourselves and take good care of yourselves in the meantime. Back to Santa Barbara, where the people know me.